Man, I broke my phone screen. Does anyone have any yttrium or terbium or europium or gadolinium or tape? Hey, all you screen time junkies, Trace here for DNews. For futurists, technology is the great unifier, and the internet democratizes communication for all of humanity. The statistics organization IDC estimates 44% of the planet is on the internet in 2016. And according to Pew Research, globally 54% own smartphones. But creating devices to access this future world of technology involves pulling lots of minerals from the actual world that we still have to live in. It's probably no surprise to learn that the modern smartphone is an absurdly complex little rectangle. Inside an iPhone, for example, you can find 75 of the 118 elements on the periodic table. That's most of the elements. Did that math for you. For comparison, life needs only about 30 elements to be, well, alive. Admittedly, many of the iPhone's elements are common enough. Silicon is used to make transistors, those tiny on-off switches that form the basis of microchips. Aluminum, silicon, potassium, and oxygen all go to the reinforced glass that covers every screen. Lithium powers an iPhone's battery, as it does in a gazillion other devices. And there's some carbon in there, of course, because, well, there's carbon in almost everything. None of that is particularly controversial. The trickier smartphone elements are the ones that are either rare or hard to harvest, or both. Gold and tin, for example, are used in electronics wiring. Gold is an excellent conductor, and tin is a critical part of the soldering process. And both are relatively rare elements, which can mean that companies end up doing business with mining outfits in countries with poor environmental and human rights records. This is why minerals like gold, tin, and tantalum are considered conflict minerals. Apple, to its credit, is working hard to source its minerals from less exploitative places. And then there are so-called rare earth minerals, a group of elements that are not actually all that rare. They're just spread around the world in small pockets and are notoriously difficult to mine. They also happen to be crucial to most electronics. These are elements like yttrium, terbium, europium, gadolinium. In iPhones, they help screens display colors, vibrating units vibrate, and speakers speak. Once again, supply is an issue here. Today, more than 90% of rare earth metals are mined in China, and the impact of those operations is not great. China's lax environmental laws have caused millions of residents living near mines to be threatened by radioactive waste and other byproducts of mineral production. So why on earth do companies continue to use these super problematic elements? Why not find an alternative? Well, they may not have much of a choice. A study at Yale University looked at all 62 metals used in the electronics industry and found that many simply had no functional substitutes, meaning we're probably stuck with them. And also meaning that companies can work hard to source materials as responsibly as possible, but at the end of the day, those elements that make up an iPhone are gonna come from all over the world. The final wrinkle here, of course, is that all of these metals and minerals are non-renewable resources. And when they are gone, that electronics industry is gonna look very different. So if there are all of these rare minerals in your phone, why does the battery still suck? We explain why here. Are there any other electronics or items you want to know about? Let us know in the comments. Please subscribe so you get more DNews and come back every day.